Hello everybody. As you see, this is a very strange typewriter. It's a book typewriter. It has also some particularities that you don't find in normal typewriters. For example, around the minute 4, I will show how it works with the majuscule shift. If you have no time to look at this video, look at least this. It's a very particular mechanism. You will not regret it. It's an Underwood Elliott Fisher from around 1930, and it's another of the 300 devices I will show in this channel. First of all, you may wonder what is a book typewriter, and why should you need to write on a book? Of course, this book typewriter can be used to type on the page of a book that lay flat when opened. But it's not the main use. For example, you could use this typewriter to write on bookkeeping ledgers. You cannot put a bookkeeping ledger in a normal typewriter like this, since you cannot remove the page and it's too thick to be inserted in the carriage. A typewriter that will write on a sheet of paper is one thing. But a typewriter that will write on a bound book without removing the page or on a piece of carton without bending it, it's quite another. So the typewriter is a solution for what you need. You can use it also in books for business records, accounting registers. You can use it also in books for business record, account registers. And also to type letters and in the same time print a carbon copy in a copy book. These situations were very common since the beginning of last century, and the company Elliott and Hatch built this typewriter since 1897. Let's see how it works. You put the book under the typewriter and it remains stationary. And when you type something, the typewriter moves on the rails. The typing bars move downward and hit the book below. Also, despite the fact the typewriter is on the book, what is being typed is visible to the operator. This is the interline. When you use this lever, these gears rotate on both sides of the typewriter. Here you can select the interlines. This typewriter was part of a complete system with a table holding the typewriter at the correct height. Probably the gears of the interline were connected to another gear on the table on which the typewriter was installed. The flat book was placed here. And when you used the interline lever, all the typewriter system moved vertically, thus writing on the next line. And with the space bar and while typing, the typewriter moved horizontally in this direction. The table probably also permitted a regulation of the distance between the typewriter and the book, allowing to write on books of different heights. There was also a foot pedal to manage the typewriter. Let's see the typing bars. It's a very particular typing bar. It seems a military pike. The minuscule and the majuscule character are in different position and are separated. There is a spring and the head of the typing bar can move in two different positions. So when you type normally, you type the minuscule character. If you want to type majuscules, you press this button and this little disc goes down. So now it's on the way of the upper part of the typing bar to hit the disc and change position, while the spring holds it in place. So now the typing bar hits the book with the other character, the majuscule. And when it returns to rest position, the bar hit the basket of the typing bars and return to normal position. Isn't it ingenious? We can also see what's inside the typewriter. There is the typing bars mechanism. The slider on this tooth bar are the margins. This is the lever to reverse the direction of the ribbon. This silver lever on the right is the tabulator, and the sliders are the tabulation stops. It works like this. This is the backspace. This is the release button to move back and forth the carriage of the typewriter. And this on the left is the return lever. This is the selector for the color of the ribbon. And this is the shift for majuscules and the shift block. Let's write something. If you like a secretary of beginning of last century. The touch is not very soft. These are the spare parts for the Elliott Fisher. You see the typing bar? Oh, I would need this. It's a carriage tie rod. It was broken and I adapted to this typewriter a tie rod of another typewriter. There are very beautiful drawings, also with the 3D effects. There was also a lamp sold as accessory. This typewriter is also presented in this Italian Underwood catalog of around 1938. You see, it's before Second World War. It says 40 workshops in main cities and colonies. There are many standard typewriters and also special typewriters and calculators. The model Fanfold and our Elliott Fisher. It says, the only one in the world writing on the flat surfaces. It allows you to build numerous documents of different formats and thickness at the same time. It also writes in bound registers, advisable for compiling minute books, for notarial works, etc. The Underwood reseller was Fornasini. I met his son in the 1980s. He bought for me the spare parts for typewriters. He was still selling typewriters like his father. That's all. I think it's a very unique kind of typewriter. Hope one day to find its table and to complete it. Have a nice day.